Hi, we're group 12, and for the topic of this research project, we have a smart grid security system. The members of our group are going to be Hector, Ricky, Julia, myself, Clinton, and George. In our research paper, we're going to go over a historical background for power grids function, how it functions, followed by the definition of smart grids and how they work and their purposes. We're going to explore their security being implemented, and as well as the vulnerabilities that are currently happening in the securities that are implemented. And we will also go over some solutions for every vulnerability that we explore.
So today's technology, everything is being adapted to use the internet, and that includes our power grids. Our power grids are evolving to become smart grids. Millions of people rely on power grids for electricity. So if we convert to smart grids, we need to take certain actions to be able to protect the smart grids and have people be able to use their power at home. So with that being said, cybersecurity is a must, and we need to start implementing it from the start.
So before we start talking about smart grids, we find that it's important to see where it all started from. So back in the 1820s, when electricity was on the rise, we had small localized energy distribution centers that ran on DC. During the big fight between Thomas Edison and Nikola Tesla, it was finally agreed that AC technology should be looked into. And the reason why alternating current is so important is because the high voltages allow the electricity to travel longer distances. And not only that, it's easier to convert to low voltages, which allow one to bring the electricity into consumers' homes. Because of these benefits and because of the fierce competition, the grid system as we know it today it came about through these interplay. And the way we know it now is huge power plants, big transmission lines that distribute power amongst various locations in entire cities, multiple towns. And as we move forward and technology advances, we're trying to revamp this ancient architecture by including communication capabilities. And this is done, this is referred to as the advanced metering infrastructure. Since we're talking about communication between different endpoints in the grid, we have to talk about protocols. So the smart grid, one of the aspects being the advanced metering infrastructure, is based on the internet protocol suite for the lower layers. So the transport layer and the network layer all use the same protocols that we use every day for the internet. Smart grids need to be different from our regular network because they must be secure, they're handling a lot more, delicate information. So therefore, all the security, all the new advancements for the smart grid take place at the application layer. And the protocol being used in this situation is called, especially for North America, is called the Distributed Network Protocol number 3. And it allows for two-way communication, authentication and encryption between all the endpoints. So the facilitation of communicating between different endpoints in the smart grid allows for more efficient energy consumption and for the power grid industry to be able to detect faults a lot quicker, which is a lot of benefits coming from it.
Okay, so when analyzing vulnerabilities of a smart grid, it's fair that we can categorize them into three categories, which include platform vulnerabilities, policy vulnerabilities, and network vulnerabilities. As for platform vulnerabilities, it's crucial that all the operating systems that are included in the smart grid have the latest patch installed. Any operating system that doesn't have the latest patch installed is exploitable to any known exploits by any attacker. As for policy vulnerabilities, most concerns lie in policies that can be implemented from security managers. Any employee that has a weak password can lead to the compromise of the entire smart grid system. As for network vulnerabilities, a network layer device poses a significant threat to the infrastructure of a smart grid. All these vulnerabilities of smart grids can be seen as real, and potential threats by looking at attacks that are attempted on a daily basis across the world. One simple example is the attack to Ukrainian power grid by the Russian group called Sandworm. They were able to attack a power grid, which led to over 200,000 customers losing power. All the plant operators were able to restore power in 6 hours by manually resetting all the breakers. Analytics say that similar attacks in a major U.S. city could lead to customers losing power for up to 6 months.
As with any cybersecurity system, smart grids also require solutions to combat these attacks. And like in cybersecurity, there are usually three techniques that we follow in order to ensure safety. And these techniques are split into three phases, which are the prevention phase, the detection phase, and the post-attack phase. During the prevention phase, you want to focus on vulnerability assessment, which is scanning all the different devices in the smart grid system and checking to see if they're vulnerable to attacks. A simple example would be if a device is connected to the internet that does not have a firewall active. That device is susceptible to an injection attack and could compromise the system. The next phase, or the detection phase, focuses on actively scanning the system and searching for attacks that might have already penetrated. Usually these attacks are in the form of passive attacks that just gather data and are used in a later time, unlike active attacks that are actively trying to harm the system. These passive attacks are sneaky and must be found in order to